What's going on, everybody? We are back with the CMP podcast, episode number 59, the mode edition. This is the mode edition because we're going to start with Blue Lock, and unfortunately, Moet was right once again.
My credit. Yes, my credit. Thank you. Please continue.
I'm going to keep it a buck. I did not like that the fact that this guy just starts the game off like shooting Steph Curry half-court shots. Like, and then the guy asks, is that legal? Like, come on, dude. Of course. Come on, man.
What I didn't like is that, well, what I was thinking, I was laughing when he's like, can I not see here? And I was like, I guess the field's too small for him to do his magic. Like, I was literally laughing already.
What's the point of your superpower if everyone else has your superpower?
I mean, the other guy was literally like, do you not know how eyes work? It was great. He was sitting behind him so he could see everything the guy can see because he's behind him.
He was confused by that. He was like, wait, he can see what I can see?
Bro, if I was Nagi during this, I was like, damn. I really want a team with this guy because he didn't do anything that entire time, except for the first shot. He did nothing. Absolutely nothing.
He didn't come up with a game plan. Nagi came up with a game plan.
Yes. Nope. Let's do 3-on-3 and then shoot. That's game plan. Good job.
Let's play the game.
God damn.
I'll be honest. I was really hyped for this episode going into it because of like last time I thought it'd be really cool. It was just a dominance, which is completely fine. I think,
but it had to be.
Yeah. It had to be, but at the same time, like, why tease me with the first goal?
Yeah, that's what they did.
Two goals?
No, they were up 1-0.
They got the first goal, and then after that, the other guys started. One dude turned into the Hulk.
That was weird. That was just weird. Yeah.
The way his muscle, that dude's a third brother, by the way.
You're talking about the third brothers. One, right? Okay, yeah.
Yeah, that's the third brother of those brothers.
The one that's what he said?
Yeah.
Or so he says?
Okay. They look just like him. He's just a scared version of them that turns into the Hulk when he tried to foul him, and the dude flexed his muscles and ran
LeBron, through. He just went LeBron on him.
Yeah, he went LeBron just ran right through him. That was tough.
I was watching this show and I was like, man, what if they call an and one in soccer? Like, how do you do that? Like, do you just score 2 points?
You get a penalty kick.
No, I don't think so. I don't think you can get an and one in soccer. That would be too much. When he was at the corner, I was like, yeah, he's going to shoot. He's going to score this.
Of course.
And one.
I was surprised how close it was, even though it was like a dominance thing. Like, I wasn't expecting it to be like 4-2.
True. 5-2. 5-3.
Yeah, 5-2.
5-2. Oh, that's even worse.
Yeah, it was. Yeah, they did kind of dominate. They didn't really stand a chance.
To be fair, did they score two or three?
Two.
It was two, yeah.
Okay.
He was like, I can see. Is what they felt like the whole, you know how everything before he did the training, you know, he had in every game, he was like, oh, I can't do this. What is my thing? The puzzles, the smash. I can see. Wait, I have to react and be where I see. And then I can predict. So, like, intuition is, like, his power or whatever. And then it feels like just, like, in the beginning of the season where he doesn't know what he's doing. I understand that you're always going to fight obstacles that are stronger than you and stuff. And you have to constantly adapt. But, man, at this point, do I have to see him completely not be able to use his quote-unquote powers again?
He got nerfed.
The guy, baited him, basically.
Yeah, I kind of did like that, though. Like, making him think that he saw something that wasn't there. Like, an illusion. But
I mean, by simply letting him go through and then running in front of him, I don't know.
Yeah,
I just like that he said, maybe you need to learn how eyes work. Like, I love that he said something like that, or he said it more insulting. But I really like that. He's like, you think I can't see?
Near the end, I kind of wanted him to like be hype about fighting competition, but like, I thought that's what he was gonna do, like on Rin's last goal, where he's like, man, I was frozen. And like, I couldn't help but be sad or something, but I wasn't sad because I was just amazed. Be hyped that you have competition or something. I thought that's what it was going to be about, but no, he's overwhelmed by the power of this guy.
I didn't like that Nagi didn't fly in this episode or like stop time in midair.
Yeah,
On the first goal.
Bro, he didn't pass it. All he did was kick the ball forward.
That first goal was also kind of weird. Like, what do you mean, Butcher? What do you mean you pass it to yourself? Like, what was that? I thought he was locking you down.
It's like you run it. It's when you pass it forward and run ahead to get it.
Yeah, you catch it.
Yeah, but this guy's long.
Yeah, that long guy was funny.
That guy was long.
The dude went like through his body like a snake and like kicked the ball.
I like that. I like that.
His hair should be illegal in soccer, though. I'm gonna be completely honest. Like, if that thing hits me while I'm running, his hair's way too long. It's not. There's no way that hair's regulation.
Oh, that's regulation.
He said, how did he get the ball through me? He's too long.
Didn't he jump over him at one point?
He jumped over Nagi.
Nagi didn't stop time, catch the ball mid spin.
I mean, this is what happens. Vegeta joined the good side, he got nerfed.
Yeah, that's true.
Nagi joined the good side. Well, it's not really a good side, but he joined the protagonist. They really didn't get
nerfed. They walked into the actual big bosses. Because these are the 1, 2, and 3.
It's only in the order that they scored, though.
Yes, they're not actually like the greatest. They just finished first.
I mean, they probably will be. They probably will. 1, 2, and 3. They said in the episode.
Who said this is just the order that they came? It's not. What do you mean?
It's the order. It's the episode in which whoever finished first got number one. Whoever finished second got number two.
Yeah. These are like the fast learners, basically.
The ones that got 100 goals quickly.
Are you guys just saying that just because that's what the dude said?
Yeah.
Like, Ego didn't say that, did he?
Ego didn't say that. He said that like 2 episodes ago. Yeah.
Okay, maybe I missed that.
But dang, they really took Bachiro. Like, what? What?
Of course they do.
What?
He's my favorite character. I don't want him to leave. Want more episodes around him.
I think it'd be cool to actually see him play with Nagi, though, because, like, he needs to do something with Nagi. Nagi's probably really regretting, like I said, being on his team. Like, the dude hasn't seen anything and done anything cool. He got a good pass from Nagi, and that was it. Whoops. He got a good pass from Nagi, and that was it.
And he got cooked by the long guy.
Quite literally, the whole time.
Yeah. You think they're going to play again?
Yeah. At 5v5, it's gonna be he's gonna get somebody from each of those teams. Yeah, it's gonna be 5v5 by the end.
You think it's gonna be 5v5? I thought it's gonna be like 4v4.
I thought it was like 8-on-8.
I thought it was 5 teams against 5 teams, 5v5. Maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, but I mean, like, to play them again while getting him back.
They can only play at the end. He has to make it to him.
Yeah, they can only play at the end.
He said, come get me, buddy. Come get me.
Whatever, next episode's going to be cool. He's probably going to end up fighting one of the two-man teams with his friend. Get one of them.
Because Nagi's boy is on their team.
Yeah, and what if... Oh, you're right. It could be between Nagi's friend and one of his teammates, because the other guy's probably getting picked, right? Either Ichigo or girl.
But what if another main character made it through and they waited for
no main characters coming through?
It's crazy. The final boss is gonna be the monk guy.
Yo, that's a crazy twist.
That would be a crazy twist.
I can't wait for that. Yeah.
I thought the way this worked was that you can like pick the same team again to play, and you just keep going and going, and you can just keep taking from the same team.
I thought it was just keep going because
when you're two players, you're at risk of elimination.
Yeah,
but you can still go for it and just take it. You're going to lose anyway.
If you have two people, you lose. You're done.
You don't go on to the next stage until you have more people.
Yeah,
you just keep staying there and fighting other losers.
Also, how would you even fight? How would you even play with less people against more people?
Well, not always, but like I imagine, like you have the option to do it.
You gain a person, and then the when the other two teams play the other threes, somebody else will gain, and then the 2 4s will play. That'll make a 5, and then like eventually it all balances out.
So you can't double dip.
There's no double dip.
Isagi's a punk, dude. I want to play the best team, and then at the last goal, he just gets frozen. Pathetic.
He tried. You see, he tried to hit it directly.
Oh, yeah, he blocked a goal, didn't he? He blocked one goal.
Yeah, he jumped in front of one goal.
They grabbed the other guy, and the other guy grew muscles.
Yeah, he tried.
He didn't grow muscles. He flexed.
Yeah, that guy had grown man strength. Excuse me, little boy.
Mama, there goes that man.
Next episode is gonna be hot. That's all I know.
No, it can't be. It can't be a good episode. This episode was supposed to be the good episode, and it was very disappointing.
Yeah, definitely disappoint me based on.
Wait, you guys didn't like this episode?
It was fine, but it was supposed to be cooler.
Yeah, it was supposed to be better.
It wasn't worth waiting an extra week.
Yeah, I should have gotten this in the end of the last episode.
Also, the intro was kind of whack.
Oh yeah, it was kind of garbage. I like the old one.
Also, somebody watched Blue Lock before me, and I thought they did an additional time in the intro. So I was watching at the very end. I was like, "What is this?"
So what do you guys give a rating there?
Seven.
That's seven.
Oh, so it's okay.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't hate it, but right. This dude's scoring corner kicks. He's too strong. He's too strong.
I mean, you didn't see when he took two soccer balls and he made them hit each other in midair?
Yeah, like, you're too strong. Like, that doesn't make any sense, but whatever.
He's the number one guy. I don't think he's number one just because he got him quickly. I think he's number one
because
he's...
Yeah, he's number one because he's number one, but...
Yeah.
Also, that dialogue between, like, soccer's life and death for me, I thought that's what Isagi said, too.
Yeah, it's not like they said the exact same thing. Like, you say soccer's life and death? Ha! Soccer's life and death.
Yeah, like, what was that? Like, soccer is my life to me. And he's like, what do you mean soccer is your life to me? It's a battlefield. And then he said it's a war, and it's like, that's the same thing. I don't know. The Crunchyroll needs to step it up with their dialogue translations.
Nah, it just went over your head. You don't get it.
I didn't realize that war and battlefield and life and death are very different things.
It's a deeper meaning. Yeah. I can't get into it now. But
yeah, I like how they also all call them psycho. Kind of crazy. It's kind of insulting.
Yeah, dude's just good. Yeah. Just good at soccer. Get over it. Maybe you should have stopped the ball in midair a couple times and won.
Yeah.
He did. Why are you hating? He did.
He didn't stop the ball in midair, dude. All he did was run forward and kick the ball that was being passed to him. He didn't stop it. He just kicked it forward.
But most of the time, they didn't even have a chance with the ball, though.
All he had to do, well, it doesn't matter, bro. He was evolving in the last game. He was evolving.
Yeah, but he
did get locked down by the teeth dude in their last 5v5 or whatever it was. V versus Z. Remember? Got locked down?
Vaguely, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Got locked up. And this dude is like a demon, so.
Yeah, of course these guys are going to smash him.
I mean, I knew they were going to smash him, but like this wasn't even fair.
Yes, number one, two, and three.
That is what it is. Whatever. It was a seven of an episode.
Yeah. I mean, there's nothing really to talk about besides that.
Let me.
This happened.
Yeah. Let me say real quick about My Hero since there wasn't anything that happened. It was a recap episode, but the last 2 minutes is all you need to know. That All For One told the Nomus to bust him out of jail. They're about to bust him out of Tartarus. It's gonna be sick. And the season's going to continue being sick. I think that's it.
That's what he said.
Trash, and there's literally no point to them. They're trash.
Recap episodes for new seasons help people that, like us, that don't know what to do, that don't watch previous seasons, to get in there. Sometimes, or don't have always the time to watch previous seasons. Recap episodes are fine.
There's a lot of two seasons that came out and that didn't have a recap episode. This is the
and
only
that's
one.
Why.
You know, I'm surprised. Yeah, but the thing about Tokyo Revengers did not have a recap.
Because every episode is a recap, okay, Chimpak? Every episode is the exact same thing. I go there, I lose my fight, I come back, I've changed the past, something else went wrong, a friend died, I go back again. Somehow, this is the worst part, by the way. He comes back to the past and still lacks confidence, but has confidence when he's a kid. It goes like, I get it, you're an adult in a kid's body, but you're still not strong or able to do anything, right? You're still the same person. Why do you lack confidence coming back and going over there? But we shouldn't talk about Tokyo because I haven't seen it yet, but you guys can talk about it.
Is that Tokyo Revengers? Is that what that is?
Why are you hating? Tokyo Eternity is a good show. You're a hater. You're just a hater. This is why you're number one on the hater power rankings, but that's another topic for another day.
But listen, My Hero gonna be hot next week and going forward.
What'd you rate this episode?
I only watched the last 2 minutes. Okay, besides saying that the heroes were dead, I only watched the last 2 minutes. The last 2 minutes were like, oh shoot, that was a Tokyo Revengers type ending.
out of 21 minutes of content, you rate 2 minutes as what?
Those 2 minutes, about an 8, because it gets me really high for next week.
See,
you give an episode an 8?
He's literally sitting there in thing talking to the nobles. He's like, my children, it's time to get me out of jail. And the episode ends. I don't know how he says it. I always paraphrase everything, bro. I didn't even remember what I watched. Like,
sure, that is true.
Yeah, by the time that happened, I couldn't, like, my brain was just turned off completely. I couldn't recall a single thing.
That's all we needed to know, though.
I'm gonna go ahead and give the episode a 2.
I would give it a 2 as well if I watched it.
Because you watched 2 minutes? 2 minutes of content.
We're moving on to Tomo is a Girl.
I like this one.
Yeah. This is probably gonna be one of the better ones of the season.
Yeah.
It felt like it was just like a bunch of stories just crammed into one, though. That's yeah, the
but, only but it really? Felt good watching it all.
Yeah, I had no problem with it, but I was just thinking, okay, we have story one. I think there's like 5 stories crammed together.
Let me hear.
The first episode, or sorry, not the first episode, but the first part was
the confession,
the main intro.
The confession. Right?
Yeah, the confession. He's like, yeah, I love you too, buddy.
That was just so funny.
That sets up the anime.
Yeah, it sets up the anime. I'm like, okay, that's cool. The second one was like the umbrella thing, right? Where the friend's like, oh no, before that, it's like the friend finds out. It's like, hey, what do you do extreme sports with the girl? He's like, yeah, of course.
I thought it was sex.
Yeah.
And then there was a misunderstanding. He has the other friend, right? The other friend that has her back. It's the friend that has her back, but she's like the manipulative friend.
Dude, I like her character. I don't know what she's planning. Like, I have no idea what she's trying to do, but she's a good character.
She's gonna fall for the other dude.
You mean you don't know she's
her? Yeah. Her and the other dude are definitely getting together.
What is she scheming then? Tell me what she's scheming.
She's trying to get them together.
Yeah, but how?
Well, first thing she's doing is she was putting the idea into the guy's head that, look, that's a girl you're hanging out with. You know that, right? You understand that, right? Like, are you aware?
Dude, that was I love, dude. They didn't say it like that, but I like how Mo phrased it.
He right though. He got pissed off too when she told him, what if he has a boyfriend?
Yeah.
She just keeps putting the idea into his head.
Then Tomo showed him her phone, right, with the picture. And it's like, oh, that's a girl. Even though everyone said it was a guy.
What? I don't remember this. What is that?
Remember the captain? It shows the picture of the captain. Oh, the captain's a girl.
The okay. two girls, right?
No, not the two girls. No, in the classroom, right after she asked the guy.
Yeah.
The picture of her with the blonde kid, right? That likes her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was just thinking to myself, like, this guy cannot fucking see gender. Like, what the hell is going on with him?
And that's a good guy. I don't see gender either.
I mean, I do think that I thought about the scene. It was funny when he hugs her and like we see a little cleavage. So she's like, "Yo, stop it!" and runs away. And then, no. I might have mixed it up. Did I mix it up?
Yeah, I think
that's my issue, right? You're mixing everything up, right?
Yeah, I mixed it up. No, I'm basically talking about the part where she ran away from him, and then he ran away from her.
Yeah, the rain scene.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Where he was under the rain all the way. So he like got hella close to her. He got up in her face.
And she was in
like needed to be under the umbrella more, and then she ran. And then he caught up to her.
And then he saw her all wet.
And he was like, oh. Yeah.
Oh my god. He was like, oh my god.
He literally handed her the umbrella. I think he bowed first. And then he ran. It was crazy.
He was literally like, oh my god.
Yeah.
What is this?
Like, oh my god.
Jesus Christ.
She's a woman.
A woman. Yeah,
all that talking from the puppeteer lady.
They tried playing. Oh, started playing right there in his head.
That's why I liked it. This anime is progressing.
Yeah.
At a nice pace already. We'll see how it goes. But
that other dude definitely falling in love with the other girl. They're going to get together too.
Oh, definitely.
And he was like, yo, you're kind of nice.
I don't think so.
Give me your umbrella. Nah, she gonna fall. She got me that. She got that Wednesday vibe.
Oh, she did take his umbrella.
Yeah,
that's
true. She's soon there. Level 5, bro.
Yeah,
I don't think she's that high.
I like how at the end, with the wrestling people in the club, he's like, "You want to fight me?" She scared the hell out of them. Oh, the girls? Yeah. And then they're like, you know what? Let me give you advice. These are my girls now.
They see me as a woman.
That's what she big bro though. That's hard.
It's gonna be a good anime. It's gonna be nice.
It's only 7.5 on my anime list.
Well, you see, Chimbak, that anime list is rated from people who don't understand love and also hate her because she don't love her. A girl. I know you love her, Chimpak. That's the perfect girl.
The one thing though, like I don't really like that little tooth thing that they have, her and her mom.
Oh, fang? You don't like the fang? I love the fang.
I don't like the fang. I'm not a fang lover.
But typically, that's for the tomboy. That's how they represent tomboyish things, characters. That's usually.
Yeah.
I like the fang.
So why does it matter?
I'm just not a fang guy.
I'm gonna put a prediction right now that sometime in this season, there's gonna be an episode where she puts her hair down or something and wears a dress, and he looks at her and like, whoa. And then you know what it's going to be? It's going to be the school festival when they do like a maid cafe or they have to do some haunted thing. I'm predicting this right now. The stereotypical maid festival or stereotypical school, you know, the thing that's everywhere, right? The school competition, school festival. And she's going to dress up and she's going to put her hair down and he's going to be like, whoa, you are a girl.
Whoa, Chin.
I'm going to predict that she goes out on a date with the yellow hair guy.
The guy sees her and he kills the guy.
Yeah, and he kills him right in the street. Yeah.
I like. Okay, so normally, like in these type of animes, like when the girl fights the guy, the girl wins. But like, she was like, "What am I supposed to do? The dude's a guy, and you're training him." She just gets beat up. Like,
that was crazy.
The fact that she says, "Yeah, he beat me up." Crazy. Like, what?
I like that he punched her in the face.
Did he punch her in the face?
Dude, what's going on with this show, man? Like.
It's progressive. Equal rights. Equal rights.
I guess. Well,
like you said, Chimpa, you don't see gender, right?
Okay, dude. I'd give it a high, maybe a mid 8. A mid 8, 8.5.
Yeah, it was a 9. It's not for me.
Yeah, 8 or 9. I'll go with it.
8.7.
There's a lot of like homey, and we're not talking about a room of this season, right? You don't want to watch it.
I am caught up.
You didn't watch it? You guys all watched it?
I did.
I did.
Yeah, I did.
It was nice. Okay, but we don't have to talk about Roma. That's fine. I would like to discuss it though after they get done with the festival. I think it'd be interesting to talk about after the festival's done. Because I think they'll get back to being really good. But I thought it was good. But I think we're that's cool. Yeah, I mean, Mason didn't see it. It's cool though. I do think that this season, though, we're watching a lot of, like, wholesome stuff. Like, we also watch Ice Guy, which I liked a lot. And I'm not talking about Ice Sorcerer, which I tried to get them to watch, and nobody did.
I watched Ice Sorcerer.
And nobody watched it at all.
I watched it.
Absolutely nobody cared about what I suggested.
Crazy that you're saying Mace is a nobody? Is that where you're playing?
No. Oh, damn. Mace, did you watch the Isekais as well? I watched
most of them.
Did you watch the Carpenter in Another World, whatever his name is?
I haven't seen that one, no.
It was like 10 stories in one. But
so what happened in Ice Kool-Aid Colleague Girl?
Chimpak, you're the best at descriptions, please.
Okay, so Ice Guy and Colleague Girl. So the Ice Guy,
her name is Cool Girl. Stop calling her Collie.
She is a colleague, though. She's a colleague.
She's a colleague. Oh, I thought you said Collie. I was like, what does that mean?
Yeah, I don't know what Kali is either.
Yeah.
Cool. They get introduced very early on in the episode. She's going through her commute and she sees this guy. He's frozen because he's so nervous. It's his first day. And guess what? It just happens to be her first day as well. And he's frozen and he's just stuck there because he's so nervous. And that's his special ability.
Yeah, his special ability is nerves.
He's a descendant of...
His special ability is nerves?
No. His special ability is he just makes ice come surround him, right? And when he gets nervous, he got frozen in ice. So like that's like, you know how you the expression.
Did anybody else on this train notice, or was it just like regular?
It's not on a train. Like she's walking.
They're walking. Oh. It seems to be not that rare that there are magical beings in that world.
Yeah,
it's not that, at least at their job.
Their job, yeah.
There's like half the people their job had something.
Like the expression like frozen in fear or something, but yeah. He's nervous.
Yeah,
I and think like... she goes out of her way to help this guy out, like out of her way. Like, you want me to pour coffee on this? It doesn't work. Oh, you want some coffee? She gives him coffee, tea, and then he drinks the tea, and he gets better because of it. And then throughout the episode, they just keep doing kind things for each other. Like, here, I'm gonna work overtime, and then he works overtime, and then she's like, hey, I will wait for you, or something. I don't know. Like, they just do nice stuff for each other, and it's nice. It's cool.
An important detail is that when the dude gets nervous or embarrassed or blushes, like a blizzard starts up, so he freezes everybody.
Yeah.
In a way.
And like, he says his favorite season is spring.
Yeah, so she got him flowers, but he told her he can never touch flowers because they freeze, but he loves them. So she got him like straw mulch or whatever, straw thingy that he could put around them. It's supposed to help from like frost and stuff. And then he said he loves cats, and she has, yeah, it did help. And he said she loves cats. Or he loves cats, and she has a cat, and she gives him whiskers that she's collected over time because they're supposed to be lucky or something. So she gave them to him, and he gets her something. What did he get her?
He got her something that she wanted off the internet that's super rare. It's like some sort of food.
Oh, so ice cream, like some sort of ice cream.
Yeah.
That was very rare. And he also
Go out of their way to help each other. Like when Joey mentioned the straw mulch, like she carried that. She said, oh, I got you the straw mulch. And he was like, aren't the people on the train going to be
annoyed that you like bump into them with this giant thing?
And but she was like, oh, no, I got the first train here when nobody else was around. So like she took the first morning train to come give him straw mulch. And then he went out of his way searching all night on the internet to give him to find that ice cream that she wanted.
Mentioned. On the internet, bro. He said for the whole week, he was checking places.
So they basically dating.
They like each other.
They don't announce it.
Yeah, and the coworkers are, you know, they obviously understand it too. And he's nice to the coworkers. He's a nice guy in general, but obviously he's extra nice to her. And that was that's the episode. Like it was just a nice, comfy episode. Very comfy. I think this is gonna be the very easy comfort thing of the season. This and Tomo.
And their boss looks like Buddha.
Yes. And they have a cat like no, they're not rub his belly.
Maybe they will though. Who knows?
So I got a question. Which show do you think is gonna have a confession or an actual love scene first? Tomo or this ice guy and
this one.
Colleague? Ice guy for sure. Probably ice guy for sure.
Tomo literally already had one, but
He had the confession the first 9 seconds. But I agree. I think it's gonna be ice guy for sure. They're literally day one, she already poured her drink on top of his feet. Like, that's my drink. Right? This is my first day of work. What if I'm thirsty? What if I need this to survive and do my thing? But
Wait, what do you mean? She poured it.
She opened up her tea.
Some episodes that would be a microaggression, Joey.
She got tea. I like she bought that. Tea from the store and she poured the tea that she already had onto his ice on his feet.
And then she gave her some of his lunch, her lunch, or some of the snacks she packed too. This was in the morning.
You understand keep it exactly a buck. I'm not doing any of this for my coworkers.
You don't even want to go to work.
Exactly.
Not even the ones you might find attractive?
No, absolutely not.
Okay. I'll just say that. Trick.
We forgot to add one thing. She's like when she was in high school and everything. Yeah, you go ahead. You can say it.
She's a normal person.
Okay, that's not what I was trying to say. she has her personality is really like deadpan. Nothing really shocks her. She's like a really chill. Like nothing really shocks her. And then she likes to talk to a cat. Today I saw something quite special.
That is true. She's a cool colleague.
Yeah, she's very chill and cool.
And she's normal.
Chill.
She's a normal. She's a descendant of humans.
No magic.
No magic.
Magic. No, it's going to be revealed later that she's part something.
Yeah, she's like part.
Yeah.
She's part fairy.
She's part volcano.
Yeah, that's my favorite. Oh no. When ice meets fire. So we're going to be talking about Vinland Saga next week, right? And a few other things as well.
It comes out in 2 days.
Yeah. So we're going to 100% write down in the chat after this video, what we're talking about next week, and pin it so I know what to watch.
And that's the last episode, last show that we all watched was called an original from Crunchyroll, Revengers. Revenger.
We didn't see it though.
I didn't see it. Yeah.
Wait, you suggested it.
What? I suggested I see sorcerer. I can even control F and say I see sorcerer.
You linked it and says people are saying this is the anime of the season. Which is crazy to say at all. Say that?
Was it Revengers I linked? I thought I said let me scroll up. I definitely didn't watch it yet.
that's crazy.
On the 5th, January 5th, it's right there.
I linked Tomo and I said Revenger. I said someone called this top 5 anime of the year after episode 1. I didn't say we watch it. I just linked that.
I mean, what do you want us to think? What do you want us to think, Joey?
Bro, my words were there that said, let's watch Icy Sorcerer because I love trash isekai and reincarnation crap. That's not an isekai, by the way. It's just a reincarnation thing. But that's the stuff I like. I love trash isekai and reincarnation crap and sports anime.
This guy posts a page where you're supposed to watch the video. Says this is going to be a top 5 anime of the season.
You know what?
And then didn't watch.
Sorcerer.
Is he going to type that in the chat? That would be very devastating for me.
So as you see, we said, I'll watch it come out Monday, so I should have some time. And you guys said, I don't know about Revengers. Feels kind of ass. And then Mace, Joey, Vinland, yes, no. Mace said yes. I said, I'll have to join now. I said, Ice Sorcerer. And that's what I said. What do you want from me?
What? I don't know.
I don't know how to be. This is why I said three times this week, we need to write down what we're watching. Because the list was Vinland, Blue Lock, My Hero, Ice Guy, and Tomo. And under it, it said maybe Revenger and Nier. Maybe. It said maybe.
It's Tokyo Revengers. That wasn't Revengers.
Damn. Then see, that wasn't even the list when I asked three times.
Yeah, Tokyo.
That's why. If we could just write down what I gotta watch next week.
Well, Revengers was ass.
You can talk about it.
Revengers was ass.
I really liked Revengers though. It wasn't. It was like a short film almost. Like the way it was paced and everything. I like stuff like that where it's faster paced.
Yeah, the plot was really good.
You guys think agree everything with the top comment I read?
Everything else is kind of whack, though.
You agree with the top comment that it's anime? That's potential to be anime of the year?
No, it's not. It's
I watched 5 anime so far, so yes, it's top 5 anime of the year.
No,
I don't think what happened? What happened?
Okay. So this guy, he's a swordsman, right? He has a job, and he's the best. What does Wolverine say about himself?
It's Wolven time.
No, Wolverine.
Oh, I love that line. I dream to forget.
I have a job and I'm the best in the world at it or something.
I'm the best at what I do
and what I do best isn't very nice. That's what this guy is. The best at what he does isn't very nice. And so there's an opium trade going on in Japan and the Dutch and the English are trying to capitalize on it. And they have a port in Japan, and they're trying to, you know, spread some opium. And
oh boy, opium!
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm. It's like this takes place in like the 1800s or maybe early 1900s. I don't know when opium.
Back when the market was good for that pick.
Yes,
ooh,
yes.
Really get it off. Are you kidding me?
My favorite market.
And so apparently,
that's what I want to be reincarnated to.
Apparently, his father-in-law. Gosh darn it!
Sorry, God.
Go ahead.
So apparently his father-in-law was involved in this opium trade, and so his boss is like, "Hey man, you got to take care of this." And so in the beginning of the episode,
hold on, pay attention to this part closely because this is important. Let's go back real quickly. His boss told him. His boss just came up to him one day and he was like, "Yo, your father-in-law, he's a huge drug lord. Go kill him."
Yeah. And so he sees them, and they're traveling in packs, and there's three guys, and in the beginning, the opening scene is like, oh, it's you, and it's like, yeah, it's like, he didn't say a single word, and he just flashes them all up, and then his father-in-law is dying, he like takes a coin out of his pocket, and then he bites on it, and then
Two-Face.
He didn't say, yo, I heard that you were stealing opium, or He didn't get to, when the boss came up to him, it was like, yo, your father-in-law, like, you know, your fiance's dad, he's stealing you. He wasn't like, oh, is there any evidence or anything like that?
No, you know what he said? Oh, bet. He said, oh, bet.
Oh, bet. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Went immediately, no words. He didn't even say hi. He couldn't even get a hi first. Slashed him up. That's your father. I sat there watching and I was like, what am I watching? What's going on? What's happening? Why did he just kill this dude?
That's anime of the year?
I still didn't even understand why that happened.
Have you guys seen Gintama?
No.
Yes, no. I have. It's a great anime.
The guy who comes in and he's like the detective for this thing, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Is like the guy's murderer. He looks exactly like Gintoki, and they both have the white hair. They do that weird hand thing where he rests his hand inside his kimono. And guess what his job is? He does odd jobs, which is what Gintoki does in Gintama.
So it's the opium. Entire time. It's all the opium.
Yeah, the entire time I was just thinking to myself, they just copy and paste this guy.
I mean, to be fair, that happens in a lot of anime. Like, most characters are copy-pasted of last time.
Yeah. Plus, the hand of the kimono thing, that's kind of classic. I don't know if what anime.
I know it's classic, but it's too many coincidences.
If they're like me, they're probably just holding up their pants.
True.
Or their shorts or whatever they're wearing.
Real gangsta.
Maybe they have like a stress ball in there.
Yeah, wouldn't know what it is. He got a hand on his gun.
I can't believe that Joey is denying the fact that he said to not watch this anime.
I didn't say watch it. I literally linked a picture that they said this is top. This is the year. That's all I said.
I like
about
how all three of us watched it, and then the person that suggested it did not even try.
You didn't even suggest it. I just put a picture and thought, because I was looking.
Right? You guys have that look.
Like, yeah, I get the misunderstanding, but what I usually do is when there's a new season, I go through, I don't read the episode one synopsis or see them, I read the comments that are not spoilers and see how people feedback, right? Like, you know, obviously something has a bunch of likes, a bunch of billion things, like, okay, this is interesting, this is going to be something I want to check out, and if it doesn't, whatever, that's the first thing I saw. I literally linked the comment as well, that's the first thing I saw, I was like, this guy said this is going to be anime of the year. What do we think, guys? I didn't even say what do we think. I just literally said that statement and kept going with my day.
Joey literally baited us.
Oh man. But
just like how he baited us with watching Shinobi no Itoki.
Look, that was my fault. We should have watched Beast Tamers.
That is true too.
But come on, episode one wasn't even bad. He dodged a car.
It was bad. I said it was bad.
Episode one was bad. I literally said it. You was the one, you was like, nah, he jumped over a truck, so it's cool. And I was like, I don't know.
Listen, man. All I know, I'm gonna watch Revenger next week just because I'm being forced to. But
what do you mean? You forced us to do it?
Bad. We can drop. Yeah.
I'll watch it regardless, right? Like, I don't care, bad or good. I'll watch it either regardless.
And then at the end, he like sneaks away, kills the dude anyway, and then his girl couldn't wait a day. She just decided to kill herself that night and through the neck. Like,
it's the most efficient way.
Damn, it sounds like a rough. It sounds like a rough time.
You know what's crazy? I'm like, was he going to her house to kill himself in front of her? Is that
yes,
what he's doing?
Yeah.
Yes.
He was.
Like this.
He was gonna run in, slide in like, on his knees, and just like cut his stomach open. Like, it was crazy.
That's good. I'm glad you guys enjoyed it.
No, the show is trash.
No, it was really good. It's
all over the place. You want to talk about
the plot? Has like the betrayal, the whole, if there was a little bit more sinister, like you said, like if he like covered up evidence instead of like him just being a blatant slave and just killing his father-in-law, it would have been better. But
jeez, next thing you know, it's gonna be some bullshit. It's gonna be like, aha, that wasn't even your father-in-law you killed, that was your father-in-law's brother. It's gonna be some dumb bullshit that comes up.
Good times. Great anime. Can't wait to get a synopsis next week as well. I'll watch it eventually. But I'm not going to talk about it. I'm going to try and convince everybody about it though. So as I said to everybody not too long ago, I love trash anime, but it has to be trash that like follows. They're okay. So this is why I like Isekai, right? It's basically like my hallmark movies, right? You know exactly what's going to happen in a Hallmark movie, right? The girl or guy goes to town that she grew up in, finds guy that she had a crush on, but is also moving away and trying to be a reporter or whatever in the big city. They start falling with each other. She gets an offer in the city. They fall out. She decides to come back. They end up together. My mom loves Hallmark movies because that's literally what happens in every single one of them. Every single one. Literally every single one. That's what a isekai is for me. Dude goes to a different world, gets powers, harem up, does good, wins at the end. Right? This is what I like. I also like the reincarnation, because the second guy is like reincarnation to another world, but there's also, you know, the genre of reincarnation into the same world. So like the, you know, the demon dude reincarnating or whatever. Like that's why we're watching Misfit Demon King, you know, you think simply killing me, yeah, me and Moet, you think simply killing me would make me die? Like, are you dumb? Like, of course that wouldn't make me die. Shoot. So that's the type of thing I like to watch. Now, in this section, I want each of us to try and convince the other to watch something that we're watching that's not on the list. I will go last because I want to.
I guess I'll go first.
Yeah. So. You know which one you have to convince. You don't have a choice. I know I have to. You don't have a choice. You don't have a choice.
I didn't want to watch it too. Like, I watched the first episode. I don't even like it, but I will convince everyone to watch it. Okay. So my life is Inukai Son's Dog. All right. Greatest anime of the year.
What is it in English? What is it?
10 out of 10. What?
What is that in English?
My life as Inukai Son's Dog.
He literally taught English.
I thought you said the Japanese name. Okay. My life as Inukai Son's Dog?
Yeah.
Okay. So this is a show about from the POV of somebody's dog.
Yeah. So, okay, this is what happens. Guy is passed out on the ground. It takes him not one, but 5 whole minutes to realize. No, not even 5. It's like 10 minutes to realize that he became a dog. All right. Okay. He's looking himself in the mirror. It's like he sees his reflection. He's like, oh, I'm a dog now. It takes him 10 minutes to realize that. Then he realizes he has a tail and is touching the girl in an inappropriate place. And they take a bath together. And it's this peak anime from there. Okay. Like, you have everything you want. You want naked girl, you have dog.
No, you're right. I see the whole anime from here. I can see every episode.
It's basically what white girls do with their dogs all the time. That's the anime.
And so you enjoyed it? Like, it was a good one? Like,
no, I hate plot, no, it was actually horrible.
How'd the plot go?
I hated every moment of it.
It was 12 minutes long, and I was just like, this is garbage.
Wait, the episode was only 12 minutes?
Yeah, it's a 12-minute episode.
Oh,
one of them.
That's super charged.
It's one of them, probably a hentai somewhere else episodes.
1000%. This is a hentai.
Somewhere. It was uncensored when I saw it, but it's definitely like something you see on like I don't know sites.
Yeah, this is episode one of the hentai.
Oh right, Hentai Haven. You'll see this on Hentai Haven.
I believe it. When you search for uncensored, I believe it.
Well, this is definitely the CMP podcast, aka Hentai Haven.
Yeah, this is something you'll see on this channel.
Mm. I guess the show, just know how it progresses.
You definitely convinced me not to watch it, so I appreciate that. I was on the fence about not to watch it. I wasn't actually.
A couple episodes.
Yeah, that's a red flag if you have to think about it.
I'm going to be honest, I will not be watching this, Moet, but you can definitely come here and give me summaries every week.
Nah, that's what I'm saying. I need Mace to keep watching it, to keep giving us summaries.
All right. How about in the opening, they showed 4 girls, and they're all pining over a dog, and that's my other reason. There's like nothing I can give you. That's like the best reason I can give you.
Sounds like Beast Tamer.
Not watch it.
Beast Tamers at least had like it was at least censored in a way. Like the girls were human.
Oh, these girls aren't humans.
Like humans are the girls are humans, but the main guy's a dog, so it's just blame bestiality.
Is he actually doing
something with them though? Like that's where.
Wait, what?
I mean, there were some parts that were kind of. All right, let me tell you this. I clicked on it on 9anime, and on 9anime it said 18+ right there on top of like the poster.
That's nothing like. Yeah, that sounds like.
It's good to see that 9anime is promoting safe watching practices, though.
Oh my goodness, yeah. This is hilarious. Yeah, you gotta keep watching it.
Yeah, keep me updated.
Yeah, you gotta keep it updated.
Every week, I'll give you a summary of what happens.
Holy shit!
First episode, they took a bath together.
You know what that anime reminds me of?
Full Metal Alchemist.
It reminds me a lot of Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood.
I was joking when I said that.
No? Okay.
Why? Is it the dog and girl thing?
Yeah. Like the dog and girl theme is like very iconic. And Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood probably does it the best out of any anime I watched.
Combining them?
I mean, they definitely were combining in this series.
Mm. Yeah, I mean, the other anime that I think would do a decent job at that, but doesn't really execute it that well, is Spike's Family, but yeah.
True, Spike's Family does a good job, too.
Take that back, first of all. True. I will not have you ruin a wholesome anime like Spike's Family.
Name one more. You don't have one more in you.
Dog Girl?
Yeah.
Dog Girl. Pokemon.
Ooh, that's perfect. A reach.
Yeah,
perfect. Thank you. Thank you for this.
That's a reach.
Then gotta get up my synopsis of mine.
Can we talk about a different anime now?
We'll move on to Chimpak because he has what was the name of yours that you were talking
my
about?
My anime is called Bungo Stray Dogs.
Describe the anime because none of us have even watched season one.
So Bungo Stray Dogs. Let me just talk to you. Let me just give you three words, right? Action.
Stray Dogs?
Mystery. Supernatural. Can I interest you in that? Let me give you themes. Adult cast. Organized crime. Superpower. All of these things are very relevant in Bungo Stray Dogs. Synonyms are literary stray dogs. Background. No background information has been added to this title. Help improve our database by adding background information here.
That's in background right now. That's in background.
Yeah.
Okay.
Type it in right now.
So basically the main character is a kid and he has superpowers.
Wait, I thought he was adult cast.
Yeah.
But he's 18. He's 18. Okay. 18 kid. 18-year-old kid. He's kicked out of the orphanage. He's left hungry, homeless, and wandering the city. And guess what?
Nice.
He turns into a werewolf.
That's dope.
And because he turns into a werewolf, he has no memories of this. He doesn't know how to control his powers because nobody taught him how to control his powers. Meanwhile, there's a detective agency trying to figure out what this werewolf is up to. And there's a mafia, and then he eventually joins the detective agency. He gets trained by the detective agency.
The werewolf or the mafia?
The werewolf joins the detective agency. He's the main character.
So he's hunting himself.
No, they figure out that he's the guy, and then they stop hunting him. Because they did the research, and they figured out that it was him. And he's, like, not a bad guy. He's just a werewolf that doesn't know what he's doing.
Did he eat people when he turned to a werewolf?
What? No, he didn't. He was just causing some ruckus.
What did he eat when he was hungry and he turned into a werewolf?
He's abruptly kicked out of the orphanage and left hungry. He's wandering.
Right.
So he's hungry.
He was a mindless werewolf, right?
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't know what he's doing.
So anyways, there's mafia, there's organized crime.
I didn't know what he ate when he was a werewolf.
Yeah. He's starving. He's literally, if you're hungry, are you eating anything? You're not eating anything. That's what hungry means. You mean you're hungry for food. You have hunger for food.
Probably eat a
person. when you're starving, when the definition of starving means that you don't have energy meaning you don't have food, so he's not eating anything.
Him being a werewolf,
if you're a werewolf,
super strength,
dude. I don't need this right now. I don't need this.
What is it that's making me that makes you want to watch it, Chen?
Yeah. Dude, every character in this show is beautiful. The art is beautiful. It's good voice acting. They have Reiner as a voice actor in this.
Reiner!
This guy.
Reiner doesn't say Reiner. Reiner. That's Aaron. But I understand where you're coming from, of course. And, like, it's a detective show as well. So, like, they try to solve a little mystery here and there. You know, it's a classic Japanese, I was thinking of what you were thinking, so I thought of what you thought. And then I love that. It happens in Hunter x Hunter, and that's what makes Hunter x Hunter beautiful as well.
Nice.
And there's foils to each character, which Aaron, Reiner, Aang, Zuko.
Mm-hmm.
It's It just adds to beautiful storytelling. There's four seasons. Wait, and this current season is a prequel.
You saw the others? Oh, wait, then why can't I could watch this first then without having to see the other ones. Perfect.
I guess.
Yeah. It's a prequel.
Yeah, it's, I guess.
Oh.
I could actually watch it. All right, what about you, Moet? Convince me. What you watching?
I've already convinced
him. My show?
What trash are we watching, Moet, this season?
The only one that I've watched that everybody else hasn't watched is the one that we watched, of course, and that's Misfit of Demon Academy.
You gotta convince them, bro. You gotta convince them.
I'm not. Trash, I already watched it. Oh, wait, it was trash. I'm
convincing people it's trash.
You gotta convince them to watch it.
Oh, to watch it. Oh shit! But it's trash.
It's good, bro. It's good. Look,
Misfit of Demon Academy. It's actually like, have you ever seen? You're gone like through somebody else's trash. And seen...
Yeah, but what was he eating?
Huh?
What was he eating in the trash?
Donuts. But what? You found
why like, is he eating donuts?
Bill in their trash?
Yeah.
It's like that. It's like a $5 bill in somebody else's trash can.
Okay.
Worth reaching in and getting.
Exactly. So it's a classic fantasy anime theme, I believe. I haven't seen it before, but I'm pretty sure this is the first one. Where it's a OP character who comes back in a different form and nobody knows like how powerful he is or what his true identity is, except for maybe like a couple of girl characters that he hangs around. Maybe if this show is feeling frisky, maybe one guy character knows, maybe, but usually not. And then as time goes on, like he shows a little bit more and more of his power. And some people start to pick up on, okay, this guy has something to him. Other people will try and get jealous and try and attack him or do certain things, attack the people around him. And he'll have to save them eventually or retaliate against the people that are attacking him. And then at the end, some greater force comes and causes a giant disturbance, and he's kind of forced to show his hand on how powerful he is. You know, it's trash. It's trash. I don't know what else to say.
And he says some beautiful lines. Like, you think killing me would make me die? He always says one-liners like that that make no sense, but they work out for him. And the best part is, season 2, episode 1, he was already called out by the teacher, and he said, this is the new demon, this is the demon lord, the same guy from back then.
Yeah, he called him out immediately, because he was actually the bad guy.
He was a god from the past, right, that he had killed, and, because gods don't really die, apparently. So what he ended up doing was he killed him anyway, because of course, he killed him again.
But he killed him.
He killed him when if the god died, the world would be destroyed. So he killed him for like
2,000 years.
Yeah. But I'm saying he killed him again here. But he revived him and left him with 1/10 of his power, so that way he can't be as crazy.
Oh, that was my favorite part of season 1 is when that guy tried to face him in the ring, and he kept killing him and reviving him over and over again. That was a good part. Yes. Yeah, watch Misfit of Demon Academy. It's trash.
That's what I do in Pokemon when I'm playing with Palmot.
Oh, you kill and revive over and over again?
Yeah.
Nice.
My turn. You guys said I could pick one, and it's Ice Sorcerer, so we're all watching it. You're welcome.
I already watched it. I'm not convinced of watching it.
What, Mace? What didn't you like about it? It was Ice Sorcerer.
The beginning was really good with like the intro. Like it felt like
the intro was fire.
Like the last episode. The intro was good. It was great. It felt like the last episode, and that's the only reason I might watch it next week.
Yes.
But once they got to the school, I kid you not, like 5 minutes after, I couldn't recall a single thing that happened.
Well, it's because school. This guy was like, "Hello, sir. Hello, ma'am. I'm this." But it turns out basically the dude's some reincarnation, or the dude's the same guy that was supposed to have disappeared years ago, and he's the Ice Sorcerer. And
he's the Avatar.
Yeah, he's an ordinary in a rich school, right? He's the first ordinary ever in a rich school, and everybody hates him. You know, it's standard that rich guy hates him because he's rich.
Add ice to it.
That's so it's not five. It's not $5. It's probably like a $1 bill, but it's still worth. Still worth. You know, and then that's my anime. We are gonna watch. Add ice to it. Exactly. Add some ice.
See, I liked it, but I didn't want to go back to school. Like, remember Shinobi in Tokyo? We spent 3 episodes in the school. I'm like, oh my god, this is hard.
Okay, but this is magic school, so this is different. They're actually going to be fighting, and you know, there's going to be some demon that comes out and some crap.
All right, maybe, maybe he has potential, but right now I'm on the
fence. He's going to beat the crap out of this one guy. He beat the bully in the first episode too, but he didn't do it good enough. Like, he only broke his sword. Yeah, unfortunately.
That sucks.
But it'll be fine. It'll eventually be good. Ish.
I'm gonna go ahead and give Ice Sorcerer a 3 now for this season.
You can't give it a 3.
Yeah, I'm gonna give it a 3 now.
You cannot give it a 3 for the season before you watch it.
Yeah, I can. I think I can safely.
Oh man. Poor boy.
Can I give my actual recommendation?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna go with like chilling in my 30s after getting fired from the team. Army.
Oh yeah, that's another trash that I'll be watching.
That keep on? I wanted to watch that anyway.
Yeah, that's trash I'm gonna be watching. You don't have to convince me of that, bro. It's trash.
I don't think that one's gonna be trash. Wait, Mace, is it trash?
It's like 50-50.
Perfect.
It's like
exactly what I want.
When I was watching it, I was like, Chimpak would not like this.
Well, that's perfect. That's what I like to hear.
Yeah, I might really enjoy it though.
Yeah. Yeah, no. I think it might be my favorite thing this season.
Yeah.
Chimpak ain't gonna like it.
Yeah, because there's a woman in it and the guy's just horny for the girl like the entire time. I'm like, okay.
I mean, Tomo-chan is horny for the guy.
True.
Kind of, but she
yeah.
True.
But everyone thinks she's a guy, so it's different.
What?
No, only one
person.
Yeah.
And ladies, maybe, apparently.
Maybe her dad too.
Dude, he really asked her. Her dad is crazy. He really asked her. So what if your friend got a boyfriend? Would you care and want them still to be friends anymore or some crap like that? Like, what a wuss. How are you always upfront with her about things and then that you're scared of? I hope she does go on a date.
It's like a classic trope where it's like the guy doesn't know how to confront his own feelings first.
Yeah.
And it'll take like 8 episodes for that to happen.
That's why I'm wondering.
You said 8 episodes?
It'll probably take
eight seasons?
No shot.
Yeah, this definitely seems like something that lasts for like 8 seasons.
No, because I'm telling you, she's going to go on a date with him, the yellow hair guy, episode 4 or 5.
Yeah, and then like the next episode, they're going to go like 5 steps backwards. That's what's going to happen.
No, I don't believe that. I have faith in this anime to be good. I'm gonna. We're gonna see.
I think it's gonna be good too.
No, it's definitely going to be good, but I don't think it's gonna like push the plot forward.
And well, that's bad then. Then it's bad.
No, you can still have a good anime that doesn't push the plot. Like Spy X Family, they push the plot for like 24
episodes. It pushes P.
It's pushing P.
Thank you.
How's it not pushing P?
Alright, last episode that he finally meets the main antagonist after 24 episodes.
That was an exception to the rule.
That was the only time the plot moved forward. Otherwise it's just family stuff.
The plot is the family stuff.
Yeah, the family stuff, that's the whole story.
That's just character interaction. That's not the plot. That's the story. That's not the plot. There's a difference.
No, the story is Spy X Family. It's not Twilight.
Yeah. And he's talking Twilight, not the movie, but the character. He's keeping it a buck. No bars.
And I'm talking about Twilight, the movie.
Tell him.
So my point is, you know, it's about the family. It's what I was talking about with Irma. I don't want to see other people in Irma because the show, the title is Irma. In My Hero, Deku's name isn't in My Hero. You can show me everybody. I don't really care. Like, I go based off what the show, what the title says.
It's called Irma's Demon School. It could literally show 500 characters if it wanted to, because it's not him.
It's not Irma. It's Irma's Demon School. Irma's
school. It's a school. It's a school.
What are you talking about?
I don't know.
You're asking me if I want to see Sasuke in Naruto. No, nigga, I want to see Naruto.
Yeah, it's called One Piece, not Monkey D. Luffy.
Yeah. I don't give a fuck about that, nigga.
I just know this is going to be a great season for farming a Sekai.
Yeah, overall, I'm going to give this season so far a 6 out of 10. Mm-hmm. Oh, Nier, are we watching this?
I watched it, yeah.
They said it was bad.
Who?
Yeah. They said it was bad.
I believe
it. I didn't say it was bad. I just think it wasn't good.
That sounds bad to me.
Like, I think the animation was good.
Yeah,
like the animation was good, but the actual like storytelling, I wasn't engaged. I feel like if it was like 15 minutes shorter, like if it was like a 5-minute clip you saw like every week, I wouldn't mind it so much.
I like the
ending. The game based off anything? Or
yeah, the game was based off the game.
Okay.
Also, the voice actor for 2B is Mikasa Ackerman.
Oh, Mikasa.
Oh, that's crazy. Oh,
that's where I heard her from.
No, she says Ere.
Ere. Ere. God, she got so annoying when she stopped killing and just start questioning everything. Like,
that is misogynistic, but
no, it's not.
It is not what it is.
It's really not. Her character,
no, it's actually progressive.
Her character for 2 seasons would simply slash, and that was the greatest thing about her. She would slash. She was the cool. She was the badass. Then she started like, is this what I'm supposed to do? Do I do it because I love him? Yo, don't matter. Just do it. You're good. That's all I wanted.
I didn't watch it, so I have to believe you.
Unless when's the final season coming out?
Who knows?
I think it's at the end of January, something like that.
Right?
Or April?
January. I think it's April. We'll see, though.
A lot of good stuff coming out in April. Like, I think Goblin Slayer season 2 is coming out.
There's no way we're watching that anymore. We ain't watching that. As someone who's watched Goblin Slayer, I can tell you right now, we're not watching Goblin Slayer.
I liked it.
It's barely about goblins anymore.
Isn't it the sequel to Inukai or something? That's what I heard.
No, it's not Inukai.
I'm watching it.
Man, I turned on Goblin Slayer. And I was like, wait, am I on Hentai Haven? What's going on?
That was just the first episode.
Oh, shit. What is happening?
Yeah, it was like, what's that? Game of Thrones. They're trying to get you in quickly with that. And then eventually they get rid of that. And there's bad stories. That
draws people in?
Yeah, that draws people in.
Oh, shit. It did not.
They had to have like seven warnings on screen, like, hey, warning, this is graphic. There's another one's like, you sure you want to watch this? Turn back now. And in the middle of the scene, it was like, you can still leave the site. That's how bad it was.
Yeah, that shit is crazy.
But you can get past the graphicness and bad stuff and watch a different show.
Yeah.
You'll be safe.
Oh, it's good. It's good. After the first episode, it's good, I swear.
I've seen it all. I've seen all of it.
I don't know.
Right. That fucking opening was like the greatest opening I've heard in a long time.
Wow. Crazy. Can't say I agree with you, Mace.
Crazy.
You didn't like the opening?
The opening of the show or the opening of the opening scene?
Like the song.
Oh, yeah. The song was good. It was like the opening of the show. Right, I liked it.
I have a random question inspired by Tomo-chan.
I might have a random answer.
What's the question?
So,
and also Joey definitely has a random answer.
So, sure. Remember the scene where they have the umbrellas and they're waiting umbrellas to. Yeah. Do you do that? Do you just wait for someone to have an umbrella? Like, do you always like need to have an umbrella when it's raining? Because I'll just walk in the rain. Like, I don't really care.
Well, I didn't grow up in Japan, so there's not a giant schoolyard that I have to walk across. Everything. I just go in the rain too, and we go on the bus.
Yeah.
Maybe. I guess it depends on like
where I'm at. So basically this question is asking you, are you an umbrella guy?
I'm a hoodie or a beanie or nothing guy.
Yeah.
Right now, no. I keep a rain jacket, like a windbreaker.
I kind of get it, though, because they're wearing uniforms and they have to wear it the next day, so it makes sense.
I hope she wears that uniform next day.
Thanks, Shimp.
Okay.
She will. She you know, she's going to school.
Okay. Just don't want her to get in trouble, you know.
That's what's up, man.
Is that it for the pod?
I think that's it. We got everything we want to talk about. We're going to watch Vinland. I'm going to watch Revenger next week. You guys said it was the greatest anime of all time. Oh, it really convinced me.
Yeah.
Killed your dad. Killed the guy who told him to kill the dad. Didn't ask questions once.
No. Insane. Killed him.
Kill him first, ask questions later. He didn't even ask questions later. I didn't explain. Like, after he killed him, he got depressed and, like, went under, like, a bridge and just stayed there.
Just started hanging out.
Yeah, maybe he should have thought about it.
Just all over the place. And that's all he was.
No. Maybe he should have thought about it before he did.
Nah, that'd be crazy. That'd be crazy.
It's not what we do out here.
With Black Panther, we don't do that here. Hold on.
We don't do that here at all.
On the forever.
That is crazy. He didn't even ask about it later. They came in, they're like, you stupid idiot. Why would your father-in-law be selling drugs? We're selling drugs, stupid.
and then he gets his sword out, and they bring out guns. So he's like, oh, shoot.
And then out of nowhere,
when they brought guns.
Like, Jesus. And they just tell him to jump. They didn't hear her voice, but I don't know how. And so he jumps into the river because God's voice told him to.
You know what it is? He's like a dog, so he has like the higher pitch hearing.
True.
That's why he listened blindly.
True. I didn't even put that together. And you know what? The show's not a 4 anymore. I'll go ahead and bump it up to a 6 for that. I didn't even catch that.
Bump it up to a 6.
That shit is trash.
Can't wait. You know what else I can't wait for?
To finally watch Tokyo Revengers Season 2, Episode 1.
Yeah, I gotta watch that. Like, I can't believe why is it? I hate that they're putting it on different things now. Like, why do I gotta get a Hulu account to watch it?
Plex.
Why do I have to remember my Plex account to watch it?
Your Plex account isn't your Gmail?
No.
Oh.
I don't know what it was.
I'm signing with my Gmail.
Hmm.
Yeah, Disney bought the rights to it. Disney needed the. It's on Disney Plus too, I think.
Disney
Plus is weird because they had this anime called Summertime Rendering on Disney Plus, and like they just had it hold. They held it hostage. Like, I don't think anybody's watched on Disney Plus. They just watched it on illegal websites, like I did. It was a pretty good anime, by the way. Summertime Rendering, 8 out of 10.
This is why it's so dumb that we have all these streaming services, but that's what it is, right?
Which is what the episode of Tokyo Revengers Season 2, Episode 1 is called.
That's what it is?
Yes.
Okay.
So, I'm just going to say it, like, before the next podcast. Tokyo Revengers is written by, like, some 8-year-old kid who, like, tries to think of, like, what gangs are. It's written by an 8-year-old. That's all I'm going to say. There's no complexity to it. It's just basic, like, oh, good guys are good, bad guys are bad. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
There's no nuance.
I guess.
You don't think good guys are good and bad guys are bad?
I'm just perspective. Well, you taught me that.
True. True. Alrighty. Hope you guys enjoyed. See you all next
time. That wasn't part of the pod. Cut that out.